Of course, actually, all the kung fu can be used to self-defense. What you mentioned, some looks like kung fu, actually it's called wushu or something like kung fu dancing. That's different from the kung fu. That's just for the stage performance, just like gymnastic or the low level gymnastic, right? But kung fu, all the kung fu including praying mantis, the purpose to have the form to record the fighting concept or techniques in the form. Because before we don't have the
YouTube
videos, we cannot record all the techniques. So the creators just make the techniques or concepts combine into the forms. And then from the forms can pass down by the generations. But you need to decode the concept inside. Some people will misunderstanding some movements. They don't know how to use it. But I'm lucky. I'm fortunate. I can decode these techniques from my sifus. Mm-hmm. So that's why I want to share it you guys. Yeah, praying mantis is some of the movement is for the self defense. Some was for the stage fighting, or some of for the street fighting. That's a different concept. For example, for this movement, this movement is not for the stage fighting, but it's good for the street fighting or some people want to bully you. If you're a girl, some people want to bully you. He won't, okay, I want to bully you. No, this is this stage fighting. Mm-hmm. We all go to the fighting positions, right? Mm-hmm. But in the street, some people just want to push you. At this time, you can grab him and dislocate his shoulders. Mm-hmm. Or make him shock.
Right.
Yeah, this is the different concept. For example, we have this one. We hit the eyeball, but this is illegal in the stage fighting.
You can't do it. Stage fighting, you mean sports, right?
Sports.
Competitive.
Competitive. Okay. But this is for the real self-defense. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So in mantis, there are many illegal moves you cannot use in sports.
No.
Because it's used for street.
Street fighting, no. Yeah. Totally different concept.
Okay.
But you can use some of the techniques in the stage fighting. Depends on how to use it. Mm-hmm. But sometimes you need to change the movement. So I always emphasize to tell my students, praying mantis is actually the fighting concept more important than the fighting techniques or the movement. The concept is alive, you can change by the situations, but the techniques or the movements only fit for one situation. It's totally different. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I want to share this knowledge to you this in the videos.
Great, thank you.
Okay. I think praying mantis is just like the Tai Chi or Wing Chun. It's more like the defensive system, not the offensive system. So you need to control your enemy first before you launch a strike. So we have the principle in Chinese called Bu Diao Bu Da. When you hooking and then punching to avoid the lucky punches.
Right. So you don't punch unless you have a grab person.
You need to control.
Control the person before you attack.
Yeah. Including the grabbing, mm-hmm. or go to the very good positions, angles. For example, we're using the paksao, right? Mm-hmm. Paksao, right? Paksao. I avoid the punch, and then go to the good angle, and then to mm-hmm. do the striking. punching, it's good, but sometimes you, even though you are very good, but sometimes you can have the beat by the lucky punch, right. And then you'll be KO. Yeah, mm-hmm. That's the idea. But when you control the person, you need to use this timing. We call feng diao bi da. That means when you hooking the person or control him, and then you need to launch the striking at once. Don't waste the timing. I think praying mantis is more because it's combined different styles of the Asian Chinese martial arts. So when you practice, you feel very fun, because including the striking, kicking, long distance, rest distance, wrestling, joint lockings, very fun.
Right. That's lots to learn.
Yeah, lots to learn. Yeah. In plain Mantis, for example, in plain Mantis, most of the movement actually is the concept, not the techniques or the simple movement.
So what's the difference?
Difference is, for example, like plain Mantis, the bumbo form, the first movement we call Pak Sao Chong Choi, right? Right, this one. This movement is a technique. When you punch me, I block and then punch you back. Punch not the head, actually punch your acupoint. Punch here. Make your diaphragm spasm.
Mm-hmm.
This is the technique. We call technique of the movement.
Right.
But from this one, we can see the concept inside. You can change all the time. For this movement, we have the blocking, avoiding, at the same time punching. This is the concept. So we can change. Also blocking, but like this time I hit your head, uppercut. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Blocking, give you a puncture.
Mm-hmm.
Right? It all belongs to this concept. So the concept means inside can change. See, to fit the situations, the real situations, but not the fixed movement.
Right.
It's different. Yeah, change. Depends on the situation.
Depends on the situation.
Yeah.
Because in the fight, nothing is always the same.
No. So when we train my students, I always using the concept and then using some target to let him to have the different situation to get the response. When you have the response, that means the Kung Fu become your body. Go to your body.
Internalize.
Yeah, internalize. Not you need to remember, he punched me, I need to block and punch, that is not real.
Right. Yeah. Because you don't have time to think.
Yeah, no time. You just make your Kung Fu become your natural response. That's really important.
Mm-hmm. So that's why you need to learn the concept.
Concept, right. and form the response.
Mm-hmm.
The good response.
Okay.